Steve Anderson can be described in three words. Clams, clarets and condoms. Clams, he's a massive seafood fan. Clarets, he likes the old Chateau Calypso. And condoms, because his new singles comedy club could be sponsored by you-know-who, and we don't mean Schweppes. Steve's a man who aims for the stars. Charlton Heston, in fact. He invited the Hollywood heavyweight to the closing show of OGI Monday, his West End comedy club. Later on, we'll see if he hit the mark.
Scottish, I've got a bit of a mixed in. I'm actually half African, half Scottish, which means I've got a tribe, a clan, a blowpipe, and a bagpipe.
I thought, I'll have a bit of fun with her. Her name was Marjorie. I said, Marjorie, listen, sorry about earlier. No hard feelings, okay? Would you like a free cocktail before you go? She went, oh, yes, please. I said, once upon a time, there was this very lonely penis, and it won the lottery and lived happily ever after. So it's a cocktail.
Hi, David Tilton, psychiatry.
It's about time.
Sorry, it's absolute mayhem today. It's Stephen, right?
You know him?
Oh, yes, he has been referred to us a couple of times.
I don't believe this. Why the hell isn't it in his records? Especially if he's dangerous. One of my staff was seriously assaulted, and we should have known. Why aren't his notes in records?
They're probably still caught up in the system, sorry. And he isn't usually violent. Well, except with members of his own family. Is that Stephen?
I don't know, I suppose so.
Who's that?
Roxy, the nurse he attacked.
Oh.
Sophie. Well, they don't even look the same.
It's always the same name, but he won't tell us who she is. Did you notice anything to upset him?
No, she did not.
Okay, well, maybe it's the hospital environment and the fact that he's off his medication.
Whatever it was, I want him out of here as soon as possible, so would you just get on and section him, please?
Okay.
Excuse me.
Hello, Stephen. Remember me?
No. No, I was waiting for someone, a nurse.
Do you know her name?
Sophie? Why are you asking me this? What do you want?
I'm Dr. Tilton. You were going to come upstairs and we're going to have a chat about your medication. How do you feel about it? Are you ready to go?
I'm fine now. I don't need medication. It stops me drawing.
Okay, well, let's go upstairs anyway, eh? Listen, sorry again about the notes, yeah? I will try and get the system sorted out, okay?
Jamie to the busy hustle and bustle of Camden Town in London for a lesson in composure with celebrity doubles acting and confidence coach Stephen Anderson. In order to get Angelina's air of elegance in time for her challenge, Stephen's taken Jamie to a quiet street for a lesson in deportment.
You are the multi-million dollar star. You're the daughter of one of Hollywood's most famous actors, okay? Remember all that. You'd have done this sort of stuff many, many times before. It's like water off a duck's back for you. You're turning up, it's just another red carpet.
Acting coach Stephen Anderson is starting her tuition by seeing if she knows how to get out of a car like a lady.
One of the things when you're going to a celebrity showbiz bash, you can guarantee there's going to be a ton of paparazzi and they're all going to be trying to photograph you getting out of the car. We're going to try some exercises to actually get you out of the car without revealing what underwear you're wearing.
Okay.
Yep, if at all any, which a lot of them don't.
Okay. We'll have the exclusive screening of the brand new Bryan Adams video, and we'll also be seeing the London Boys of Pasadena singing live in the studio a little later.
Good evening and welcome back to the UK's number one chart show. Tonight we feature American Mariah Carey live by satellite from the USA.
And the highest new entry this week goes in at number five. You can see Kylie Minogue singing live later.
And of course, there's a brand new number one from Wet 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 who we'll be seeing later on in the show. Somerset making the Top of the Pops debut, here's Sharp with Rhubarb and Custard.
There's a new regime.
If you want to be here, we're very happy to have you here and to work with you and to get to those goals and destinations. But if you're not, toddle off, we'll get someone else in that ears. That's all I'm saying. First of all, can I say welcome back to the Fit Farm. But more importantly, welcome back to phase two of Fit Farm.
Since first meeting them, Gail's been vocal in her criticism of the new team. Manager Stephen asked to see her to sort things out.
Gail. How are you feeling?
Pissed off.
Yeah? OK, Gail, let's take it to the real basic level here, OK? Because I'm here to run a really happy ship. I want to run a tight, happy ship.
I've got people out there that are dedicated, that want to work. Mm-hmm. I've got people that want to reach their goals. Mm-hmm. I saw your goal, mm-hmm. which was to slim down just before your operation, to be able to wear a nice mini skirt, to wear some nice clothing. I thought, brilliant. Mm-hmm. But you just don't seem happy here. You don't seem like a team player. The attitude's wrong. And late for sessions and stuff, and always excuses. She knew we were coming for her next after Gail left, and she's done a really, really, really good manipulation job. That's what she's done, but she's done it in a very, very sort of cosy way. And she came back yesterday saying, oh, Stephen, yeah, can't wait to get in that gym tonight. She didn't go to bed till 11, but she was pooped. I think if you're pooped, you go to bed about 8, maybe 9 o'clock. She went at 11. Nothing in the gym. This morning, she actually only did 15 minutes on the bike, and it was an hour on the treadmill. That was it. That's what she did. That's what she calls doing her card. And as soon as you start to investigate stuff like that, she doesn't like it. She gets on the defensive.
Ace communicator Stephen Anderson, actor, writer, stand-up performer, to help them find that special someone they would like to meet.
Oh, here comes the top. The jacket's coming off.
Where did his eyes go? Wait, watch. Oh, go on, look.
Oh, the dude.
Your parents are still down in Devon?
I cannot believe there could be no guy in the world that... Drop your eyes, just drop them a little bit.
Though.
What guys tend to do, they try and work a crafty way as the girl looks away to check them out. Yeah. And he hasn't even done that. It doesn't even look as though he's lining up a crafty way to have a little bit of a peek. He was a bit gobsmacked and swept away when she first turned up in the denim jacket, stunning. And then suddenly she takes the jacket off, looks like a supermodel. He's bound to be panicked and freaked out. So confidence-wise, you've got to sort that out.
Now, earlier on, Jill actually asked, if you feel you make your partner uncomfortable, please stand up. I know John did. I'll come to you in a second, John, but you didn't, Peter. Why don't you feel you do?
Well, I've looked after her for 21 years.
Yeah.
To the best of my ability.
Okay.
And I don't think I know I admit that I'm rather dominant in the relationship. Okay. But I still don't think I make her feel uncomfortable.
Okay, well, you said earlier that you are trying to repair the relationship.
Yeah.
And it sounded as though you were prepared to perhaps sort of compromise on, you know, what's making her uncomfortable,
yeah.
Sort of 18 hours.
Yeah, we have.
Could you stand up, if you are serious about repairing the relationship, could you sort of stand up, and as Colin's just done there, and say something nice that you like about your partner?
Certainly. You want her to stand up?
No.
This is Pamela.
Yeah.
We've been together 21 years.
Yeah.
And I love her dearly.
Yeah.
Right, and she's also the mother of two of my children.
Yeah.
Right, who I'm very, very proud of.
What else do you like about her?
She's a good cook.
Yeah.
She looks after me.
Okay.
Right, and it's through her I'm like this.
Yeah. Okay, take a seat.
Are you prepared? Now you've had a bit of breathing space for the last sort of 8 weeks. You're 15 miles apart. Are you prepared to perhaps try and give it a go as boyfriend, girlfriend, but to sort of start afresh?
I am prepared to give it a go.
To give it a go.
But that doesn't mean to say the ultimate goal will be living together.
No.
This is what I'm trying to explain to everybody.
Let me finish. In doing that.
I don't think they are.
Colin, sorry, let me just finish. In doing that, would you also be prepared to be faithful to Barbara?
If it was an exclusive relationship, yeah. Then the faithfulness would be with an exclusive relationship, obviously. Yes.
Even though you're living in separate houses.
Yes.